to Jerry now with a huge opportunity at Unforgiven. And speaking of huge opportunities, one lucky lady has the opportunity of a lifetime to become a Raw Diva and win $250,000. Last week on Raw, I had the tough job, as always, of relaying some bad news to another Diva hopeful. Here they are, the seven remaining Diva contestants who will be voted off tonight. We're about to find out. Before we get to that, though, earlier today, we asked each Diva that if they could vote off a fellow contestant, who would they vote off and why?
If I had to vote off one of the other girls, not to be like mean or anything, but it would definitely be Carmella. She doesn't really want to be here. I know that she doesn't want it.
I think she's just in it to win another contract and not make it a career with the WWE.
She's laughed at all the tests that we've had to do to prove ourselves to you, the audience. She wasn't there for Diva Dodgeball, and we had to do it without her. I've talked to a lot of my friends, and they said she kind of reminds them of a dish rig.
She does not feel like she's as excited and wants this as much as every one of the other divas.
It would definitely be Carmella.
The only question is, Carmella, did you vote for yourself?
It would probably be Joy. If I had to pick one, I'd say her, just because she is married and she has babies, and it'd be really hard to find the time, I guess, to do this.
Okay, now that we know who the contestants won off, let's find out who the audience did vote off. And the diva going home tonight is Michelle.
Michelle, was that just a shock to you? Did you see it coming? Did you think tonight would be the night you go home?
You know, you never see it coming, but I expected nothing coming into it, so I've gotten everything. It's been great.
What do you think to say to the fans who did support you, who did vote for you?
Thank you so much, especially back home in Palatka. Look, everyone.
Surprise to me, too.
Hey, look, there's my boy, Raven. The following contest is scheduled for football. Introducing first from Charlottesville, Virginia, weighing 230 pounds, Maven.
Coach, I think everybody was caught off guard by the fact that Michelle was winning.
Here's what I said. If the voting would have been after SummerSlam, Michelle would still be around. So Michelle dominated Diva Dodgeball SummerSlam.
Oh, she was like a kid. She was firing the balls.
And by the way, if I'm one of our Raw Divas, I'm embarrassed.
True, I would be too.
That was despicable. That was just bad. They got their butts whooped in Diva Dodgeball.
But it was very enjoyable watching that many women with their hands on balls.
Yes, it was.
Man.
Yes, it was.
Loved it.
Well, here we go. Maven, the young prodigy of Al Snow, and taking on...
Dances with Bob Ganoush. Up to the arm drag by Maven, keeping major control of Dances with Baba Ganoush.
Well, still to come here on Heat, if I can gain my composure.
Would you try? I'm trying to be a professional here and call the match. Maven taking on a worthy opponent.
We still have to show everybody that Randy Orton had to defend his World Heavyweight title the very next night on Raw after SummerSlam, and you will not believe the shocking ending if you have not seen it as of yet.
And the shock on Randy Orton's face when he found out he had to defend it less than 24 hours after he won the World Heavyweight Championship. Beautiful black heel trip by Maven into an arm drag on Dancing with Baba Ganoush again.
You know, when I look at Maven, and I've said this many times, and you have as well.
Yes.
I think if put in the right situation, that Maven has star written all over him.
Absolutely. He has got so much charisma. The guy has got so much potential and talent. He just got to be careful, because he's young, that he doesn't get too cocky, too arrogant. Oh, beautiful drop kick. And another one. Cover, hook the leg.
Once again, playing the role of the coach, Al Snow, everybody.
I'm sorry, I get excited.
I know you do. You get extra excited when Maven's in the ring. What do you mean by has to watch out that he doesn't get too cocky, too excited?
Well, a little early on in the match, I noticed he took Dancing with Baba Ganoush down, who's now stepping out through the ropes. And then, like right now, careless. He's taking for granted that this guy is not as experienced as he probably is.
And now caught on that top rope. Do you think maybe that Maven hasn't had the direction by somebody that he needs to have over the last couple of years? And maybe, as I said, if put in the right situation, that would certainly help him.
Absolutely. I think that he needs a little bit of guidance, and he could just reach his full potential.
Oh!
Chop to the crowd like he's an Atlanta Braves game or Cleveland Indians. Cover him.
Maven just had the wind completely knocked out of him, but now attempting with the help of this crowd to get back to his feet.
And you see all the heart that Maven has. He just keeps fighting.
Now a couple of elbows to the midsection, but cut off again. A big forearm to the back of the neck and the back of the upper back of Maven.
And after
does
what
that make sense, by the way?
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay,
it's all
cool.
In the back.
Well,
yeah.
Same thing.
Yeah.
But
plenty of people have said Maven got back.
Well, yes, he does.
Yeah. He's got junk in the trunk.
And the women seem to love that about Maven. I've hung out with Maven through the years a couple of times.
Oh, yeah.
Certainly getting women for Maven is not a hard thing to do.
No, it's not like for you and I where we got to get the ball in the
easy,
floor.
Easy, easy. You talk about yourself. You've been out with the coach. You know what the coach is all about when it comes to the honeys, as I like to call it.
Maven on the block. Oh. And right into the knee. Now follow up. Get your movement there. Get it going.
Maven screaming, get up, come on, give me another one, big clothesline. And now Maven obviously has now got the upper hand.
And dances with Bogdanovich.
He's got cover, two to the leg, two on him. Kick out Maven nearly with a victory right there.
Dances with Bogdanovich was obliging by just continuing to get back up. Beautiful snap, suplex. Ooh, nip up, baby.
Shades of the great one. And Maven going to the top rope. And what's he going to do here?
Taking a little too much time.
He's going to give the cross body, but reversal by Dance with Bobby Ganudo. What a huge upset this would have been. Nearly a three count on Maven.
Oh, my gosh.
Maven nearly.
Oh, I'd have been so hot if he'd have lost.
And that's something we just would not want.
Oh, no. I don't think Maven would have won
well,
either.
Well, now Maven. Oh!
Still ahead on Heat, the big Balboski faces off against Rodney Mack.
But coming up next.
So you go out there tonight, you be Randy Orton. You put out all that talent, all that ability, and you let Evolution take care of the rest.